Hi guys, you're watching the EJ Tech Show. My name is Deepit and today I have with me the iQOO Z5. Now the performance-focused iQOO brand promises a great gaming experience along with a good camera, all for a starting price of ₹23,990. Before I get into how well it does any of those things, make sure you hit that like button and do subscribe to our channel to not miss out on the latest in tech. The iQOO Z5 has an appealing design language. It has this matte textured finish and tasteful color gradients. This review unit is the Arctic Dawn color, which I really like, but it's also available in the Mystic Space color variant. The camera bump, in contrast, is a mirror finish jet black color, which looks really nice against this white color. The phone is plastic all around, but feels good to hold in hand, thanks to the extremely tapered back edges. In fact, the back curves so much that the right edge has to cut through the curve to accommodate the volume and power buttons, which is actually a nice little design touch. You also get the charging port, SIM tray and speaker grill on the bottom, and a nice little surprise on top. Yes, that's a headphone jack. The front panel has the display with the centered punch hole camera cutout, which really helps the phone look more premium even with the moderately sized bezels. Let's get into the meat of it. Just how well does the iQOO Z5 perform? Well, let's talk about the specs first. Under the hood is the latest Snapdragon 770 8G chipset, coupled with up to 12GB of LPDDR5 RAM as opposed to LPDDR4X, which is more common in this price range, and up to 256GB UFS 3.1 storage as opposed to UFS 2.1. The inclusion of these high-performance parts, both of which are quite nice to get at this price range, means that the phone absolutely zips along in general usage. Multitasking is buttery smooth and there's no hint of stutter when using social media apps or the camera. Honestly, I wouldn't expect anything less from a Snapdragon 770 8G powered smartphone. But one area where this phone truly shines is gaming. In Call of Duty Mobile, the iQOO Z5 can run at max frame rate on high graphics settings. You can push it to very high graphics with a high frame rate, but this is a competitive FPS. You know that frame rate is more important. Games load up really fast and the interface is quite smooth as well. You'll have a similar experience with BGMI, where the game runs at HD settings at ultra frame rates. The gameplay is, as expected, very smooth, especially with the 240Hz touch sampling rate. You also get a dedicated GameSpace app on the home screen, where you can see and launch all supported games, and it tracks playtime and things like that. Weirdly enough, I didn't find any options to manually add games to this launcher, so if it doesn't auto-detect your games, you're kind of out of luck. In-game, you can swipe in this overlay from the left. You'll see the current CPU and GPU speeds along with your playtime and battery status. You can also choose between the power saving, balanced, and monster modes. The monster mode will optimize everything for maximum performance at the cost of battery life. Of course, the real test of this phone is something like Genshin Impact. And well, the Snapdragon 770 8G works really well here. Genshin works pretty smoothly at low settings with a 30fps frame rate. iQOO has put in a liquid cooling system in the Z5, which means that performance with heavy games like Genshin Impact does not get worse over time. It used to be the case that you wouldn't even bother with the camera on gaming phones because it was understood that it's going to be bad. Well, Asus can take a note from iQOO's handbook here because the camera on the iQOO Z5 is pretty great. There's a 64MP main camera, an 8MP ultrawide, and a 2MP macro lens on the back. The main camera takes good photos in bright daylight. It defaults to a high contrast look with very muted colors, which looks fairly natural in most situations. Dynamic range is also pretty good, although in some situations the HDR can kick in and make the colors look weird. Indoors, the camera still takes fairly accurate shots which can get a little grainy but represent color well. The ultra-wide camera is about okay, useful for shooting landscapes or wide shots in bright daylight, but it doesn't get a lot of detail. The iQOO Z5 can also shoot video at up to 4K 30fps. Video has decent dynamic range too, and with EIS, movement is quite smooth. The front camera is a 16MP unit and it takes decent shots both indoors and outdoors. Sometimes it can overexpose in bright daylight, so you'll need to watch out for highlights. Now, this display is an IPS LCD panel instead of an AMOLED one. It's a 6.67 Full HD Plus panel that can do up to 120Hz refresh rate. But more importantly, the colors are really vivid on this one. contrast is very nice and black levels are brilliant for an LCD. You even get HDR10 support and the viewing angles are quite good. Overall, this is a fantastic display for watching content and playing games. Up to 650 nits peak brightness means that the phone is quite usable in daylight as well. The fingerprint scanner on this phone is on the power button and it's extremely accurate and fast. The iQOO Z5 also has stereo speakers, which is a big inclusion for this price point. It's a pretty loud system that doesn't compromise on the clarity much at high volumes. It's not going to replace a Bluetooth speaker, but for watching shows or even some listening to music, it's a big upgrade from only one speaker. I know most of us have moved on to Bluetooth earphones or dongles, but mobile gamers will really appreciate the inclusion of a headphone jack. I quite like the placement on the top as well, not many phones do that. If you still care about it, it's here. The iQOO Z5 runs FunTouch OS 12, although still based on Android 11. FunTouch OS has a lot of customization options and some extra useful features on top of Android. There are some preloaded apps, most of which you can easily remove, but some you can't even disable, which can be quite annoying. At least the iQOO Z5 has a good battery life. The 5000 mAh battery gave me 6 to 7 hours of screen time regularly on a single charge, with heavy usage that involved a lot of gaming, watching videos and listening to music. And this is with the screen set to 120Hz. If you knock it down to 60Hz, this is an easy 2-day battery. The included 44W flash charge adapter can bring this phone from 0 to 100 in just under an hour, which is quite fast as well. The iQOO Z5 is a phone focused on performance, and perform it does. It offers a fast chipset, a good camera, and great battery life at a terrific price point. If you're looking for a gaming phone under 25,000 rupees, it doesn't get much better than this.